she's good enough. I'll offer cards down on the table, knowing there's no way that you'll be able.
Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. My name is Chelsea. I'm a second year middle school math and science teacher. That is the last time that I will ever say that because today is the last day of school. Okay guys, so today is the last day of school. I am dressed and I'm about to make my coffee and make my lunch and head out for the day. But yeah, I cannot believe my second year is ending today. Well, technically tomorrow. Tomorrow is my last like contract day because it's teacher work day tomorrow. But today is my last day with kids and I can't believe it. Like on one hand, I'm sad and I'm emotional and like I can't believe that the year went by so fast. But on the other hand, I'm very excited for next year because so much is changing next year. I'm gonna be a third year. I'm only teaching math. I'm changing rooms. Like so much is changing that I'm like torn on how to feel. So I don't know how I feel this morning other than excited to go hang out with my kids. So today we're not gonna be doing anything. We're just gonna be hanging out, playing games. I'm probably gonna play games with them. So yeah, I'm just excited to have fun with the kids today. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and make my coffee really quick. My kitchen is an absolute disaster. So I'm gonna try to not show you that. Also, we get the ugly lights. I really need to change these lights, but I picked up yesterday the Starbucks Nespresso pods because I'm tired of being cheap and just using like the instant espresso to make like whipped coffee. So I'm gonna put you here and it's gonna be an awkward angle and I apologize, but it's so that you don't see the literal disgustingness that's around you. But these are only single espresso shots. I got two boxes though to last me through, you know, the week, because I like a double, well, I really like a triple espresso, but that's, we don't need to do all that. So I'm just gonna get a cup. So yeah, I thought that I would bring you along on a last day of school vlog, and I might combine this with tomorrow because tomorrow is teacher work day, but I haven't decided yet. I don't know if I'm gonna give you two separate vlogs or not, so we'll see how much footage I get from today. But I'm just put some salted caramel syrup in my coffee, and I made my lunch while I was waiting for my coffee to get done. I just have a salad with some bacon, sliced almonds, and then I got feta cheese, but I got like tomato basil feta cheese. I've never seen it before, so I got that. And then there's also some chicken breast and some like regular onions, and then some honey mustard for my dressing. Dots pretzels. If you haven't had Dots pretzels, try them. The red bag are my favorite, but the honey mustard ones are really good too. I haven't tried the blue bag yet though. And then I picked up some strawberries and blueberries yesterday at the store too. And I'm just gonna finish off my coffee with some milk and some ice, and then we'll be ready to go.
Okay, hi. So it is actually the end of the day. It's currently 4:30 and we're officially done with the school year, at least with the kids. We still have to come in tomorrow for a teacher work day, but the kids are officially on summer break. And it ended up being a pretty good day, all things considering. So that was awesome. The kids pretty much just hung out and we just had kind of like fun and hung out with each other. So that was a nice end of the year. So I am gonna stay after for like two more hours, mainly because one of my friends is trying to grade and she needs somebody to motivate her, so I volunteered. But also I did find out that I am gonna be able to move into my room maybe tomorrow or maybe right after tomorrow, maybe like Thursday or something, which I am planning on being here for a little bit on Thursday. So I am gonna go ahead and start to pack up my room. Also, my room is an absolute disaster. So I am going to work on my room a little bit today and a little bit tomorrow during teacher work day and try and get some stuff done. So I thought that I would show you guys a little bit of that and make this kind of like also a classroom pack up part 2. I can't remember, but yeah, let's do that. Okay, quick update. I'm watching Fairly Odd Parents on YouTube. Quick update though, I wanna show you just what I've done so far. So far, I just pulled all of my paper out of the back room. So this is all paper that was open, and then all of my paper that wasn't open. And then I've got labels here. I've got dividers, all that kind of stuff. So I just pulled all of that out and I want to show you the closet. So even though I really worked hard on spray painting these guys. If you, I think I vlogged it last year, or at least showed you. I spray painted some of these. I'm just going to leave them all. I don't like them, and I thought that I would like holding my paper in them, but it just makes the papers bend, so I think I'm going to hold my paper or, like, organize my paper in, what am I trying to say? Not organize. Anyway, I'm just going to have my paper be on those, like, black acrylic or plastic shelves. So I'm going to leave these in here for the teacher that comes in next. This is completely empty, so I'm good on that. And then I have all of these. Now, these we got free at the end of the year because I think they either ordered too many or Walmart was giving a bunch of them away. So I took a bunch. I am just going to take the white ones that I grabbed and those pink ones, and then I'm going to leave all the rest of them, mainly because they're all the way up there and I don't feel like climbing up there to get them. But I'm going to leave the teacher that's coming in some empty binders to go, like, to use, because the other binders, I don't have any more binders in here. So I want the teacher that's coming in here to have some binders. So my next task is to take all these binders that I'm taking out and try and fit them in here. And then I'm also going to do that with, I've got a couple binders in here, and then all of these folders are coming with me. Those folders and the manila folders are gonna go in that box. So that's next. Afternoon, because it's 4:50 now, and like I said, I'm probably gonna be here till like 6 or 6:30. My goal is to get as much of my stuff from the back room out into the classroom, because now I don't have to worry about taking it all the way to the back of my classroom. It can just be on my tables. So that's the goal. So I'm gonna try and move as fast as possible. I don't have that much stuff, but I've got a decent amount to get through. So I'm trying to move. That way I don't have to be in the back room at all tomorrow. So that's the goal.
Guys, I'm done. So other than trash, everything is out of my back room, which I'm gonna do trash tomorrow. Oh my gosh, it's so weird to have everything out of, like, that I'm keeping out of this back room. So I'm gonna show you around really quick. This is feeling more like emotional and real. Like I said this morning, I haven't really felt emotional, but this is like, this feels real. Like, stuff is out of my back room. Like, I'm moving rooms. That's crazy. So let me show you around my back room. And then it's 5:53. I'll show you everything, because literally now everything is out in my classroom. And it's not terrible. I kind of organized it as much as possible, but I have a lot of work to do still. So let me show you back here, and then I'll probably get ready to leave. So, like, this is trash. I have to throw this away. But I left just a couple of things. I mean, most of this stuff is mine, so I took it. And then I didn't leave anything in that cabinet. I will probably be throwing this away because it's bowed anyway. And I won't have anywhere to hang it next year. Or I mean, I might, I don't know. I might keep it. We'll see. And then in here, there's just, I left a little bag, and then, that umbrella has been in here, so I'm leaving that. There's binders in here. I ended up leaving that whole second shelf as well, because I have a ton of those that I forgot about as well. So I have a ton of binders, so I'm just gonna leave all these binders in here. They're all empty. But this is completely empty. This is completely empty, and that has some science stuff. These are all old books, so they can throw them away if they want to, because I put them all up there so that it was, like, in the way, out of the way. Oh, I need this. This is my book from back when I was studying the wrong thing. So just in case I ever want to get my middle school math. I already paid for the book, so I gotta keep this. But yeah, I organized it up there so that it was all out of the way. Same with all those books. So they might not even need to throw it away, but I did organize it for my needs last year, so it's all up there. And then science books, I don't know if science is getting new books or not next year, so I kept all those in here. And I kept the math books as well, just because I'm not throwing them away. There's old jars down there that weren't mine, so I kept those in there.
But all of my stuff that was in all these drawers and all these cabinets is completely out. This is all trash that was back here, or stuff that I'm throwing away that I don't feel right like leaving in here. So I will trash all of this tomorrow when we have trash cans because they're too full from locker cleanouts. But all of this, I'm leaving the Kinects because they're more science than math. So I'm leaving the Kinects. They're not mine. I think all of this, I never actually went through these. Yeah, I don't need any of that. I don't need those. I don't need lanyards. What's back there? Nope, those are dog tags. I don't need them. And I don't think I need any of this stuff. Like, this is all really old supplies and stuff. I don't even know. What is this? Tag topper punch. I don't know what that means. If you know what this is, tell me. Because I have no idea what that is. But yeah. I don't need any of this stuff, so that can all stay. And then there's a ton of, like, old material in these two that I never used, but I put back here. Again, the old science books. I don't know what they're doing with science next year, so that's staying back here. These are carts that I put one of them together, and I didn't put the other one together. But that's not mine, so that's staying in here. This was a wine cart that one of the teachers had in here before me, and I didn't, like, it's broken. I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it wobbles really badly. But I don't want it. So it's literally just been back here on the way. So that's staying because I'm not trying to throw that away. I emptied all my stuff out of there. Finally, don't have to worry about this stupid desk anymore. I hated this desk so much. Both years I was in here, I begged for it to be gone and it wasn't ever gone. And stuff, I just threw stuff on here. So don't have to worry about that. But these are science books that I left. This, I actually need to figure out if this is registered to my name or not because the district gave us this last year for COVID. So I probably need to check on this, honestly. But, and then that, I don't remember where that came from, but it's not mine. The only other thing that is mine that I do have to take is the mini fridge. And this is going to my parents' house. I did not use this at all this year, but it's going to go to my parents' house because it's essentially new. So I am going to put that out in my classroom really quick before I go. That way I don't forget to take it to my parents' house probably tomorrow when I leave. So yeah, other than that, the back room is officially empty with my stuff. Then when we come out to the actual classroom, my desk is an absolute disaster. But there is stuff on every single table. This is like this before I started emptying, but every single table has stuff from my back room. And then I don't think that there's a ton of stuff in the back cabinets, which is good. So I think everything that you can visibly see is stuff that I have to take or take down and things like that. So yeah, there's that. Okay, so I'm at school and I just went and looked in the other teacher's room. It does look like she's all moved out because there's a lot of tables or there's a lot of chairs on tables and stuff, but she has a lot of stuff that she left in there and I so badly do not want to take my stuff into a classroom that has stuff that I know I don't want. Again, I did that with this room. I don't want to do that again. Oh my gosh, looking at my room like this is making me really sad. Anyway, so I think what I'm going to do is, she does have a lot of furniture in there that I want. So I'm gonna have to talk to my principal and make sure that all of that furniture stays because I want all of that. She has a lot of extra tables. She has a lot of like round tables and like trapezoid tables. She has like a tall like bar stool table. I want all of that stuff because I think I can use all of that stuff for small groups and for extra seating and like teacher work areas. So I really like, I want all of that furniture. So I need to talk to my principal today because they're working today before we leave and make sure that all of that furniture is gonna stay, or ask her like, do I need to go in there and label all my furniture? Because I want all of that furniture to stay in that room because it's nice furniture. But I also need to go through that room and take out stuff that I don't want and put it in the new room that I think the resource room, because that was the resource room before. I think the resource room is moving to another teacher's room, but that teacher is also moving, so we have to wait for her to move out. So I am going to just like keep it all in like a little pile, but move it all to the resource room. That way the new resource teacher has their stuff. But that I can be doing after summer school. In my room, I really don't want to put stuff in the back room. Like, that I just really don't want to. Like, that back room is finally clean. Like, I don't want it back there. So I was really hoping to not put it all back here because I didn't want the summer school kids to come in and see like a room like mostly packed. But what I could do is I could also put them in the cabinets down here because these are mostly empty. Well, they have science stuff in them, but I can put the science stuff in the back room. That way it's out of the way. It doesn't make the room look like it's being emptied out. But I also don't think that it matters that the room looks like it's going to be emptied out. Okay, I think I'm just going to try and fill the back counters with as much stuff as possible and just make it look neat and organized. That way it's not a huge deal. And then we'll move it all to my new room. Probably like the last week of summer school is when I'll start moving stuff over to the new room. But I don't know yet. So that's the plan. We're just going to move all of that stuff back here. So, and I have about 45 minutes to do it. So let's do it. Hey guys, okay, so it is actually Friday morning. It is, what time is it? 8:47. I've been up for about 20 minutes or so. But I wanted to give you a like rundown of what happened yesterday because I wasn't gonna be able to film. I knew that once my friends came because we were gonna be moving my friend Lauren's stuff from her classroom to her house. And then like I told you guys, we were meeting some of our teammates at a restaurant for lunch. So here's what my classroom looked like when I got done with it. So everything that was out on like in the classroom, but on my tables and stuff like that, I just went ahead and put it in the back of my room instead of the back closet because I don't know. I really liked that my back closet was completely emptied out. I didn't have any more stuff in there. I just didn't want to put it all back there again. I'm just ready to be done with the back room situation. So I just went ahead and put everything in the back of my classroom. Now I don't love that my summer school kids are gonna come in and see that, but I am the only classroom that is still like up, the decorations are up and everything like that. All of the other summer school rooms, like teachers went in, well, that's not true. My friend Lauren left some stuff. So, but all the other rooms are essentially like completely torn down, like bare walls, empty, everything like that, because the teachers that have them, like have those classrooms, are gone for the summer and that's what we're supposed to do. So I was kind of like, you know what, it's okay. Like at least they'll come in, they'll see like a bright, inviting classroom. They'll know that that's my style because these are gonna be, some of them are gonna be my future like students next school year. And I'm gonna be moving rooms. Like I will be telling them like, now next, you know, in August when you come back, like I won't be in this classroom, I'll be in this other classroom down here. So yeah, I did go in and see my new classroom and I'm very excited. There's a lot of space. Like that room is huge. Now there has to be put more desks in there because the teacher that had that room before me was a resource teacher and she didn't have a like full roster of kids like I did. So we have to get more desks in there. But it's a huge room. I cannot wait to show you guys. It's a huge room. There's a ton of really great furniture in there that I'm really excited to work with and figure out. I'm just excited. So I'm going to be figuring out what type of classroom theme that I want this year. I don't know if do I want a theme? Do I not want a theme? Like, I have no idea. I was originally also thinking that I would be saving my bulletin boards, but I don't think that's going to happen because if I remember correctly, that room has completely different bulletin boards. Like sizes and everything like that. So I don't even know if I'll be able to have that. Also, I left my tripod at school. So we'll see. Maybe David and I can run over there today just so I can grab it and get out. But then after we moved my friend out, we went and got lunch. We went to this place called Luciana's in Broad Ripple. And it was so much fun. I've never been to that restaurant. That it was actually really good. Oh no, did I put my food away? I really hope that I put my leftovers in the fridge because that would be really sad because it was really good. But we ended up staying there pretty much the rest of the day. Like, we closed the place down, so, which is, like, true, like, that's our style. Me and my two friends, we typically, like, will stay at a place until, like, it's closed. I don't know why. We just love to hang out and talk, and, like, it was so much fun. I feel like it was sad because one of our teammates is actually, like, moving to Florida, so I wish we would have done this earlier in the year. One of my teammates, Lauren, is just moving school, so she'll be able to come and hang out and do that kind of stuff with. But I was like, we need to start doing this, like, at least once a quarter, like, when progress reports, like, end of the quarters, we need to, like, as a team, go out and hang out, like, for a night or something like that, because it was so much fun. But yeah, I wanted to go ahead and close out the vlog here, because I realized that I really didn't talk much yesterday at all. So for this one, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like this video if you liked it and subscribe for more, and I'll see you in my next one.
But she's somebody else in the making. First, she's just gotta stop all the faking. And she's